Tequila, le sombrero.
Faritas.
Cancun.
Un kimono.
Wagyu filet.
Eiji Kawashima. One Piece.
Donc voilà, nous cherchons deux volontaires pour faire deux choses du Japon et du Mexique. Moi, le sumo et la piñata,
on est là.
Je suis OK.
Moi aussi.
Allez.
Kevin et Laurent.
C'est bon.
Attends, on a fait.
Je respire pas.
Le but, il est là-bas.
Ben oui,
viens. Mais fais gaffe si je t'arrête là.
À tous les supporters et supportrices, on vous souhaite la bienvenue pour Belgique Japon, Belgique Mexique. Olivier Tom.
Non. Tequila, le sombrero.
Faritas.
Cancun.
Un kimono.
Wagyu filet.
Eiji Kawashima. One Piece.
Donc voilà, nous cherchons deux volontaires pour faire deux choses du Japon et du Mexique. Moi, le sumo et la piñata,
on
bon.
Est là.
Je suis OK.
Moi bon. Aussi.
Allez.
Kevin et Laurent.
C'est bon.
Attends, on a fait.
Je respire pas.
Le but, il est là-bas.
Ben oui,
viens. Mais fais gaffe si je t'arrête là.
À tous les supporters et supportrices, on vous souhaite la bienvenue pour Belgique Japon, Belgique Mexique. Olivier Tom.
Non.
Tequila, le sombrero.
Faritas.
Cancun.
Un kimono.
Wagyu filet.
Eiji Kawashima. One Piece.
Donc voilà, nous cherchons deux volontaires pour faire deux choses du Japon et du Mexique. Moi, le sumo et la piñata,
on est là.
Je suis OK.
Moi bon. Aussi.
Allez.
Kevin et Laurent.
C'est bon.
Attends, on a fait.
Je respire pas.
Le but, il est là-bas.
Ben oui, viens.
Mais fais gaffe si je t'arrête là.
À tous les supporters et supportrices, on vous souhaite la bienvenue pour Belgique Japon, Belgique Mexique. Olivier Tom.
Non.
Tequila, le sombrero.
Faritas.
Cancun.
Un kimono.
Wagyu filet.
Eiji Kawashima. One Piece.
Donc voilà, nous cherchons deux volontaires pour faire deux choses du Japon et du Mexique. Moi, le sumo et la piñata,
on est là.
Je suis OK.
Moi bon. Aussi.
Allez.
Kevin et Laurent.
C'est bon.
Attends, on a fait.
Je respire pas.
Le but, il est là-bas.
Ben oui, viens.
Mais fais gaffe si je t'arrête là.
À tous les supporters et supportrices, on vous souhaite la bienvenue pour Belgique Japon, Belgique Mexique. Olivier Tom.
Non.
Tequila, le sombrero.
Faritas.
Cancun.
Un kimono.
Wagyu filet.
Eiji Kawashima. One Piece.
Donc voilà, nous cherchons deux volontaires pour faire deux choses du Japon et du Mexique. Moi, le sumo et la piñata,
on est là.
Je suis OK.
Moi aussi.
Allez.
Kevin et Laurent.
Thanks.
Goedemiddag allemaal, bonjour tout le monde, welcome everyone in het Belgian Football Center in Tubis voor de bekendmaking van de selectie van Roberto Martinez voor de twee vriendschappelijke wedstrijden tegen Mexico en Japan. Et aussi pour la sélection de Johan Wallem, le coach des moins 21, pour ses matchs contre Chypre et la Turquie. Match important pour les moins 21. Eerst een aantal praktische mededelingen. Terwijl ik ook de mensen welkom heet die van achter hun PC de livestreaming volgen. Welkom allemaal hier bij deze persconferentie. Een aantal praktische mededelingen. In zaak België-Mexico zijn er nog 5000 kaarten over. Dus nog 5000 kaarten te kopen. Er zijn nog 5000 tickets. We raden iedereen aan om tickets te kopen via onze kanalen. Belgianfootball.be, dat is het meest veilige. Op andere sites die tickets aanbieden, riskeert u van wat mis te lopen en bedrogen uit te komen. Dus daar willen we gewoon de nadruk op leggen. Donc, achetez vos tickets sur notre site, c'est le plus rassuré. Tickets voor die wedstrijd zijn te koop tot 2 uur in de namiddag op de matchdag. Donc, les tickets seront à vendre sur notre site jusqu'à le jour du match. 2 uur de l'après-midi. Japan, 20.000 tickets sold. 20.000 tickets sold for the game against Japan, for the moment. Zelfde informatie, dus graag tickets via onze website. De praktische info voor de open training. Entraînement ouverte mardi 7 novembre. Pas de bagage, 1600 personnes maximum. Les portes s'ouvrent à 16h30. Le parking est tout près de l'entrée. And the training session will be a non-smoking area, so the training venue, which one for the open training on the first day of our training camp, is a non-smoking area. Goed, dan is het nu tijd om de selecties bekend te maken. We beginnen met de selectie van de min 21. We komen als avec la sélection des moins 21 de notre coach des moins 21, Johan Wallem. La sélection pour les matchs contre Chypre et Turquie. Johan.
Merci Stéphane. Bonjour à tout le monde. Goedendag allemaal. Dus de doelmannen, les gardiens Arnaud Bodard, Nordin Jakkers en Jens Tunkens. Verdedigers, défenseur Elias Cobot, Diane Coles, Nathan de Medina, Wout Faas, Senam Yange et Jurs Schrevers. Middenvelders, milieu de terrain, Samuel Bastien, Alexis De Sar, Brian Heinen, Aristote Nkaka, Stéphane Omeanga, Sibus Schrevers en Jordi Van Leerberg. En aanvallers, attaquants, Nani Di Matta, Lea Iseka, Dodi Lukebakio, Isaac Mbenza, Julien Ngoy et Yenti Kanepil.
Merci Johan. Un mot sur les absents et leurs remplaçants, Mangala et Mae.
Oui, deux changements, Mangala et Mae blessés. Mangala est pas encore, n'a pas encore complètement récupéré. Donc voilà, deux changements à sélection et Mae s'est blessé hier. Donc, Mae is hier gekwetst op training en Mangala is nog niet volledig hersteld van zijn kwetsuur. Dus.
Zijn er vragen van Wallem, van de geschreven media mag ook? Geen vragen voor Johan Wallem. So then we'll continue with the selection for the Belgian Red Devils 2 friendly matches. Welcome Roberto Martinez. Please, your names for the matches against Mexico on the 10th and Japan on the 14th of November.
Thanks, Stefan. Good afternoon, everyone. The squad of the Red Devils to play Mexico and Japan, the two friendlies coming up, is Thibaut Courtois, Simon Mignolet, Matt Sells, Koen Castells, Jan Bertongen, Laurent Simon, Christian Cavaselle, Thomas Vermaelen, Leander Den Donker, Dedrick Boyata, Nasser Charlie, Thomas Mounier, Jordan Lukaku, Adnan Januzaj, Axel Witsel, Steven Defoe, Yuri Tillemans, Kevin De Bruyne, Moussa Dembele, Rajan Angolan, Torgan Hazard, Dries Mertens, Kevin Miralles, Eden Hazard, Logan De Poitre, Michy Batshuayi, Divo Origi en Romelu Lukaku.
Oké, okay. 28 names. Zijn er vragen? Y a-t-il des questions de la part de la télé d'abord pour Roberto Martinez? Rodrigo.
Mr. Martinez, Rodrigo Benkens, RTBF. Raja is back. It's because of his performance, or did you have a personal contact with him? We have, in French, an expression, mettre de l'eau dans son vin. Literal is to put a little water in a red wine of Catalonia. So is it, what happens?
Well, I think it's we finished our qualifying campaign. We need to remember that we work really hard to become unbeaten, to finish top seven in the world so we could be seeded in the World Cup draw, and we've done that. Now, the way we see it is a different period. Now we're preparing for the World Cup. And we've been following, as you know, we're following between 50 and 55 players. Within those players, some they've been impressive. I would say Dennis Pratt has been very, very unfortunate not to make the final call, the same way that Timothy Castagne, Jason Denayer. They've been three names that they've been very close. But then there's been opportunities for Adnan Januzaj, Laurent Depoitre and Rajan Angolan as part of a good moment of form, and is a moment to come to the national team and impress and try to work hard to be part of the team going forward.
In this list, it's the first time you give the names of Januzaj and of Depoitre. Why this choice?
Yeah, I think Adnan Januzaj is a player that we've been following closely. We all know he was part of the World Cup squad in 2014 in Brazil. His talent is undoubted. And then in the period while I've been head coach of the Red Devils, I've seen him in two clubs. One is Sunderland, where it was a difficult season. This campaign has been a very, very positive start for him. Playing is a player that is left-footed, that he can play in different positions. But the reason he's coming for the national team is to try to see if he can do the role of Yannick Carrasco. Yannick Carrasco is injured, he's going to miss out in this period. And this is the reason why we're playing two competitive teams like Japan and Mexico to get a lot of information from. And I think Adnan Januzaj has earned the opportunity to show that he could bring a similar role that Yannick Carrasco was doing in the team.
Another question, you have many injuries for your defenders. Is it possible that in one of the two games you change your system and, for example, you begin with four defenders? Or?
Well, I think there are these are the games that we're going to try things, and we're going to try to probably become flexible. We are a flexible team. I think we've seen it in the games that we played. We change things as the games go on, so I don't discount that we could change the shape, but I think it's more becoming better and better and better in what we're trying to do. The system is just a structure, it's the way you start the game, but it's the way we play. We're gonna defend quick, we're gonna press high, we're gonna win the ball back quickly, we're gonna have a real quality on the ball, we're gonna be very dynamic, and I think whichever the system we play, the concepts need to be the same. It is true that we got a couple of injuries at the back, but I think it brings a very good opportunity to two players that they already been playing or working with the Red Devils for a long time without having a lot of exposure on the pitch, which is Dedric Boyata and Christian Cavaselle, and both been working a lot at club level, and I feel that they're getting ready, and it's a good opportunity for them. It's unfortunate to lose certain players, but on the other side, it's a good opportunity for us to see how they are.
Last question for me, Mr. Martinez. We play again Mexico and Japan with all the respect for the teams. When you see that, for example, England play against Brazil and Germany, are you not disappointed about the opposition?
No, and I tell you why. I think these games, you need to be very careful that you don't play a name and you don't play a team. I think there are certain nations that it is not the same to play them in a competitive game that they are when you play them in a friendly. I think closer to the World Cup, the games are going to be very different. I just feel that for us to face different confederations, playing a team like Japan, that they had an outstanding qualifying campaign, playing against teams like Australia and teams that they were very competitive, I think it's going to be very helpful for us. And Mexico, I really rate what Mexico do on the pitch. The coach is a is a very intelligent coach. He can play different systems. I'm really, really, really looking forward to see those two teams, because they're going to be proper tests. We're not going to play against a name. We're going to play against teams that they're going to make it very, very difficult, and they're going to give us a lot of information. Exciting to go to Bruges. I think we had an incredible experience when we went to Liège and visit a different ground. We're looking forward to playing Brussels and then in Bruges. So I think for us the preparation is perfect. Going into March is going to be a different situation.
Muchas gracias.
Okay.
Nog vragen voor de televisie? Serge Vermeijden, RTL.
Hello, Mr. Martinez. About Nainggolan, did you have a contact with him? Did you go to Rome to discuss with him? And what was the reaction of the player with this selection?
No, like any other player, I followed every player very closely. I've seen Raja play live, the game against Chelsea at Stamford Bridge. He's been is showing a good moment of form. And like it's always been, I need to make very, very clear that we need to select the best possible squad to be as good as we can. And there's nothing different. I know there's been a lot of talk and a lot of supposed stories. There is nothing as glamorous as the squad needs to be a group of players of 23. And now is an opportunity to open up a little bit more and look into two friendlies and players that they are in good moments of form. As we always said, the doors will be always open.
Nog vragen voor televisie? Encore des questions pour les chaînes télé? No? Oké, dan beëindigen we hier livestreaming van deze persconferentie. Bedankt voor het kijken. En wij gaan nu de kans geven aan de mensen van de geschreven pers om vragen te stellen. Donc, des questions pour Roberto Martinez de la presse écrite.
Mr. Martinez, do you expect some changes in the behavior of Raja inside the group